Get ready to match the stars. Clifton Davis, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Rona Barrett, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers.
Hello, Johnny Olson. Thank you, dear friends and gentle hosts. Is everyone quite ready?
Ready, yes. And happy, too.
Are you all happy? That's
happy.
Good.
Happy as pigs in a pen.
Makes one and no one.
Are you chewing gum? Chewing gum is not allowed on this show.
No, I'm not chewing
eating
gum.
Eating is not allowed on this show.
I'm not eating either.
Whatever you're doing, stop it.
I'm drunk, but I'm not chewing gum or eating.
We greet you. Let's say hello to our two players here, Dorothy Sybil and Kit McCoy. Now, Dorothy's our current champ. You've won $1,400, right?
Right.
Okay. Yeah. How do you feel about that, Dorothy?
I feel great about it.
Oh, that's good. Now, let's see. We're in the middle of round two, are we? Wait a minute. Let's change the score there. It's 4-4, right? 4. That's right. That's where we are. 4-4 is the score in the middle of round two, and you're going to have one question. All you need to do is match one celebrity in order to win your third game. So we'll see how this turns out in a moment or so. So you hurry right back. I thought you'd never come back. Okay, here we go. Middle of round two. That's the situation. 4-4. Remember, Dorothy, all you do is match one celebrity to win the game. Now, who plays here? Betty and Rona. Yes.
Null and void.
Yeah.
Reading from left to right?
Yes,
no,
Dad.
You write. You right? And Betty are the only two who do this. Susie, the switchboard operator, got drunk, and instead of plugging the phone line into the switchboard, she plugged it into her blank.
Gee, that would be a good question for me.
Okay. Now we come over here to Dorothy Sybil. Sybil.
Yes.
Susie, the switchboard operator, got drunk, and instead of plugging the phone line into the switchboard, she plugged it into her...
Into her nose.
Into her nose. Into her nose. I don't know. We'll find out if nose works now. She says she plugged it into her nose. Where do you say she plugged it?
Is this my nose?
No. What is that? That's your belly button.
That's my belly button.
That's what she said. Into her belly button. And what did you say, Miss Betty White, honey?
I can't imagine her doing a thing like that.
I can't either.
She said, "Your wall, please." It was her ear.
Ear. So the game ends in a tie.
Sorry, honey.
Well, we got a tie on our hands, so we got to go to a tiebreaker. Let's clean up this mess here. Okay, and with my magic finger, I push the button, and lo and behold, I reveal two tie-breaking questions, A and B, and ask Kit McCoy to make a selection.
A.
A is what she wants, and A is what she gets. Everybody plays. It's a tiebreaker. The surgeon said to his wife, "Dear, I told you 1,000 times I cannot bring a blank home from the hospital for the dog." "Dear, I told you 1,000 times I cannot bring a blank home from the hospital for the dog."
Oh, I got it.
All right, everybody in the lower tier is ready. All right, well, you've got a better idea. Okay, there you go.
Wait a minute now.
This is one of those four-card answers, is it, Brett?
No, it's only three, sweetheart.
There is a paper shortage, you know.
In whose life?
All right, there we go. We're all set. We come over here to Kit McCoy. The surgeon said to his wife, "Dear, I told you 1,000 times I cannot bring a blank home from the hospital for the dog."
A cadaver.
A cadaver. What do you say, Clifton?
I have two Great Danes. Now, yeah. They might dig a cadaver. But most dogs dig the obvious bone.
A bone. Okay. Brett, what'd you say?
I think you made fun of me earlier on about my long answers.
Right.
But I believe that this is going to work.
Score for the lady,
lady,
is it?
Yes.
Yes, right. Every...
No, thank you. I don't need your rotten help.
Sweet.
Where were you when I needed you? I said a bunch of human bones or a skeleton.
What does that do for you? There's a match. Okay. Kit, you got one. Yes, indeed. What do you say, Charles?
I just said bone. I could only find one card.
Kit's looking for a cadaver. Let's see if we get one here.
I should have stuck with the original one, but I didn't.
What was your original one?
Well, a body or a cadaver.
Oh, you threw that away.
Yeah,
and what'd
then
you put down?
I figured you had to go for a bone.
Yeah.
I got the bones from the cadaver.
Oh, you get the bones from the cadaver. Is that the way it is, Kit?
Oh, you carve things up,
yes,
too.
This California life is strange.
That's right. Richard, what do you say? I told you 1,000 times, dear, I cannot bring a blank home from the hospital for the dog, and she said a cadaver.
You're putting me on. I said bone, dog.
Well, he likes to have meat on his bones.
That seems to be the answer. Now, do you have the conventional answer?
Clifton has a pair of Great Danes.
Yes.
I have a Great Pyrenees, but they don't show in these pants. But if you
say,
but I said bone.
Bone, all right. And I'll fight any man in this bar who says you don't. Now, one for another tie,
no,
and two for your third win. Dumb Dora is so dumb.
How dumb is she?
I'll tell you, at the bar, she tried to put a blank on a Bloody Mary. That's how dumb Dora is.
I got it.
At the bar, she tried to put a blank on a Bloody Mary. Okay.
Perfect. Perfect answer.
Is that it?
Good. Very good. Splendid.
Perfect answer.
All right, very good. Put it down there in the slot, and away we go. Dorothy, you ready?
Yes.
Listen carefully now. Just put it right in the slot there. Put it in there. There we go. Dumb Dora is so dumb, at the bar, she tried to put a blank on a Bloody Mary.
A Band-Aid.
A Band-Aid. What'd you say, Clifton?
I am stuck on bandage.
Bandage, okay. Tie score at this moment. One more Band-Aid or bandage will win the game. Brett.
Band-Aid.
There it is. What do the rest of you have? Come on now, Dorothy. Okay, you stand by there for a moment or so. And we'll say goodbye to Kit McCoy. Kit, it was a pleasure having you here.
Thank you. It was nice being here.
We wish you the best of luck, and we've got gifts for you from Match Game 75. Goodbye, Kit. And now if she's spinning off, we'll spin these messages for you, and then you hurry back and see how she does here. Here's Dorothy Seibel. This is her third time up here, so she knows how it goes. And if you know how it goes, we might as well go. Oh, I'm sorry. I just was trying. Did I hurt you? I didn't mean to do that.
My
I just had to get that out of your way because I thought you might trip over it.
Again.
So let's put it over there. And then, no. Okay. All right. Now, you ready, Dorothy?
Right.
All right. I was just stalling while they got the cameras in position. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Draw blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. You match the next one, you get $250. The bottom one gets you $100. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Richard.
Drawbridge.
Drawbridge is one.
Okay. Clifton.
Draw poker.
Draw poker.
And Rona.
Rona?
Draw a line.
Draw a line. All right. Draw bridge, draw line, draw poker. Have you got an idea in your head, or does one of those sound good to you?
No ideas in my head. I'll go with draw poker.
Draw poker is the one she wants. Let's find out if it's up there. Okay, that's the answer that Clifton gave you. Let's see if it's under the $100 response. Drawstring.
Oh.
Yes, okay. No draw poker there.
A strange group.
Yes, it was a strange group.
Drawstring nonsense.
All right, we're looking for draw poker. Here's a $250 response. Drawbridge. Okay, there's Richard's answer. Here's the last chance for draw poker. Let's see if it's under there, under the $500 number. Draw poker it is. Congratulations. Okay. Now, Dorothy.
At this moment, you haven't even $2,000. More important, you've added to your winnings, but you're going to play for 10 times $500 or $5,000. Now, to collect, you got to match one of them head-to-head. You've been here before. You know how it goes. Choose one.
Oh, this is very difficult. But I think I'll stick with Richard.
Okay, Richard, you're up.
I think that's a wise decision.
You're stuck, honey.
Yes. No. All right, you just stand right on that little line mark there and you face me. And I will get out the $5,000 question. Here we go. Trail blank. T-R-A-I-L blank. Trail blank. Or trail blank. Now, he's finished, and we ask you to give us your response, one you think will match his. Trail...
Trailblazer.
Trailblazer. Okay. Well, I don't know. We'll find out. You may hold my hand, if you wish, while we're finding out from Richard for $5,000 if you do match him, Richard. She says trailblazer.
I don't even know what that means.
Trailblazer. It's an old early American expression. People who follow
tonight.
First. You know, and when you're walking through the woods, the one who's the first one blazes the trail.
Oh. Is that from the film Trail of Billy Jack?
No. No. Has nothing to do with it.
Well, whenever I play cricket, I always wear a blazer.
A blazer. $7,000 right now. And you can play another game, so let's welcome Terry Richardson. Okay. Now, Dorothy, do you want to climb back on the merry-go-round there and say hello to Terry Richardson? As we say hello to Terry Richardson, welcome him to the program.
Thanks, sir.
And ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm an airline pilot.
Yeah.
I'm married, been married all my life, have two children. My wife's sitting out here watching us.
Now, wait a minute. You've been married all your life?
At least.
Hope your wife isn't watching.
Is your wife here?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
She's sitting out there in the
Not anymore,
she's sitting next to the to the lawyer down there. Is that your wife?
Yeah.
Yes, of course. Okay, no, where? Would you raise your hand, please, there? Where is she? The second seat in?
Row with the lime.
Hello there. Okay, nice to have you with us, Mrs. Richardson. And you fly around the country, around the world, or
around the country.
Around
mostly.
The country, mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. Yeah, we wish you the best of luck, Terry.
Thank you.
And shall we begin?
Certainly.
Are you, Dorothy? Are you ready?
Yes.
You know, we've had all kinds of winners on this program, but we've never had a weeper before, have we? Yeah. People to just cry for joy, as Dorothy is doing there. Have you got enough Kleenex?
Thanks to Charles.
Yes, Charles. I
winners
here.
I'll
just winning card.
All right, I'll just bring the whole thing over there. There's the winning card, the one that got
you
the $5,000. There's your Kleenex. We'll hide it back there so no one knows there's Kleenex there. You see? All right. Okay. Now, shall we begin? Terry, it's up to you. Do you want A or B here?
I'll try A.
A. New game. Everybody plays. Nancy Newlywed said. I think I've got a problem with my new husband. Instead of carrying me over the threshold, he carried his blank over the threshold. Good.
I have a perfect answer for that.
All right.
I have one, two.
Right. Bottom tier is ready. And here we go with the upper tier. What's that? Say it again. Oh, yes, while we're waiting. Following this show... my wife Helen and I are on Tattletales.
So what?
Having
you
the time
on Tattletales with somebody else?
No. Well, I might be able to do sometime. All right, Terry.
Gene, are you married?
Yes.
You no good animal.
Shh. You aren't going to say anything.
You.
Stop
you.
It. Shh. Quiet. Shh.
And Betty, you tell me.
People may be watching.
Do I do?
Okay, here we go, Terry. Nancy Newlywed said, "I think I've got a problem with my new husband. Instead of carrying me over the threshold, he carried his blank over the threshold."
Carried his mother.
His mother. He carried his mother over the threshold. That's a good answer.
It's pretty good. You know, one thing about...
You got a better one?
Well, I mean, I may...
I doubt that.
I mean, you know, the terrible thing about being on a show called That's My Mama is that it opens up this whole world of the dozens insults. And everybody say, "How's your mama?" Yeah. You know, and it used to be a dirty thing. And I got to take it as being something good. Maybe you will, too.
Mama! Oh-ho, there's one for Terry. All right.
Yes, Brett, what did you say?
Does Terry's wife have a good lawyer now that she's getting a divorce?
I guess so, sure.
I said mommy.
Mommy. Two for Terry. Charles?
Gene, I'd never let a pilot down.
Mother.
Mother. All right, that's three for Terry. I'm glad you wouldn't, Chuck. How about you, Rona?
Do you realize that I'm the only strange one in this group?
Oh, we've known that. That's why we got you. Yeah. We said, let's get five celebrities and one weirdo. And that's how you got booked on the show.
That's it.
What have you got?
What is a man's best friend?
Dog.
That's right.
His dog. Oh, but now that's a very logical answer.
You should see his mother.
I don't think you're a weirdo at all.
You should see his mother.
You should see his mother. All right, Richard. Instead of carrying me over the threshold, he carried his mother over the threshold, according to Terry Richardson.
Well, when I did get married, it was a long time ago, but yes. I carried my bride over, and then I carried her mother over. That's nothing unusual.
Oh, really?
Now, when my brother got married,
yes,
he really worried his wife. He carried the best man over the threshold.
He carried the best man over. Well,
that was... Goes very happy now in Omaha.
That would give a woman pause, wouldn't it?
It certainly would.
And make her a little nervous, wouldn't it, Betty?
It certainly would.
Yeah.
So I just went for an absolute on-the-money match. Mother.
Mother! Okay, four for you. He's starting off great. We'll see if you're going to continue your winning ways after this message. Ready. Here we go. Dorothy, are you ready? All right, this is your first rounder. Frank said this. He said...
Frank who?
Frank anybody. Could be
Sinatra.
George, Bill, John, who, I don't know.
You know how to hurt a person.
Shh. Gorshin?
Frank said, "I saw the strangest thing along the highway today. There was a regular road sign that said, 'Caution, deer crossing.' And then a teeny, teeny, tiny sign that said, 'Caution, blank crossing.'"
I hate that question. Now I want it repeated immediately to see if I like it any better.
A teeny tiny sign that said, "Caution, blank crossing." A regular sign on the road that said, "Caution, deer crossing." And then a teeny, teeny, tiny sign that said, "Caution, blank crossing." You see?
Oh.
Got the idea?
Yes, but I still hate it.
You still hate it? All right, Tallulah, you can hate it. Chuck, you're finished, right?
I'm okay.
It was very weeny, teeny.
Oh, teeny, weeny, tiny sign. Yeah.
Teeny,
oh, tiny, weeny, teeny, weeny, tiny one. That's a teeny, weeny sign. Come on, Brett.
Well, I finally came up with the right
answer. You see the dingbat over there holding a sign that says speed up, and you're fiddling around there. You can't even read it. I'm telling you, it says speed up.
You know backwards, that's right. Poo deeps.
Yes. Poo deeps. Dorothy, Frank said, "I saw the strangest thing along the highway today. There was a regular road sign." Are you listening to me, Dorothy?
I'm listening.
"A regular road sign that said, 'Caution, deer crossing,' and then a teeny tiny sign that said, 'Caution, blank crossing.'"
Ant
crossing. Okay, Clifton.
That's a good answer. I'm sorry, I came from the Annette Funicello group. Mouse crossing.
Mouse crossing would be good. That's a small animal, a small sign. Brett?
Well, first I had roach crossing. Then I put mice or mouse. Then I finally went with elf.
Elf crossing. Okay. Chuck?
Boy, that was a fabulously interesting story. I said mouse. I'm sorry.
All right. Dorothy is looking for an ant crossing, a teeny tiny sign that said ant crossing. What do you say?
If you give me 43 exclusives in the next year...
And is one for you, Dorothy.
All right, Richard.
I was going to say Uncle Crossing, but I said Aunt.
Aunt Crossing. There they are.
That's an American joke.
That's two for her and you, Betty.
I can't. Gotta go. The bottom row, I said Ant Crossing.
Ant Crossing. There he is. So at this moment, it's 4-3 in favor of Terry, and we got a tight game going. But right now, we got this message going for you. Now listen, friends. Next time we get together, these are the celebrities you will see on this very stage.
Edward Asner. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Julie London. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Fly.
You were all just splendid. Thank you all. Hugh Rayburn here, Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.